In the beginning, I just have a intro to what it is and to the, what you can do, like different types of readings. But you press get started and it gives you 10 different cards. And they're all shown through here. Every time you hit get started, new cards come up. Right now it's that. And then down here, I have a list of all your cards that you got and the category that they go in.
So how do you generate that list?
Through the random feature.
Right, so I mean, how you actually, if you, the first step where you have, not the random feature, but we've seen that before, but the actual list, the outcome, do you do that through a template or through a code, I think, right?
Through a code.
Okay, can you show us that code?
Sure.
Not this one.
Oh. Which one?
The next one, where you have a personalized list. Is it all the same card? Right?
Yes, it is.
Oh, okay, so yeah. Current influence is. Okay, so you're. So the basic structure that he has is you pick 7 cards, he writes the names of the tiddlers who pick the 7 cards, and then he's got those 7 cards, and you can manipulate them and transclude them as needed.
Yes.
Okay, this is similar to what Derek did, I think. Right, where you've got a whole bunch of cards and then you kind of pick and choose which one you're being evolved. Yeah. Right, so you based on characteristics, and this is similar to what we saw Ben, I think, do. Right? Okay. Yeah. And so what does a card look like? You chose one of the tiddlers for a card.
Yes.
What did you just do?
I showed, hit the, like, showed sidebar because it was hidden before.
Okay. Anybody else see that? Anybody else do that? So what we learned from that little move is that everybody uses TiddlyWiki in their own way. Most of us are content to use that little button up in the upper right that turns the sidebar on and off. The market is it. So he like finds the tiddler that says yes or no for whether the sidebar is visible and manually changes it to no yes when you want to see the sidebar. Am I right about that?
Yeah.
That's a choice. And interesting. What are the back? What's the, why do you do that?
Because there's no button for the sidebar. I don't know how else to do it.
How'd you get rid of it?
I don't know.
Does everybody else have a button for their sidebar?
Yeah.
It's like, that's just, okay. Isn't it up there somewhere? Or you have to write?
No, it's nowhere. How'd you get rid of
it?
I don't know.
Okay. But it's impressive that you figured out how it works, okay? So that tells you that everything agrees and agrees, right? So somewhere there's a path that says there's a tiddler that has a yes or no value that says whether it's the sideboard or the. That's cool. Okay. And there's the card. Okay.
Yeah. And they're all just in fields.
Yep. So you've got all the values, and then all of that is driven by the template?
No, it should be, but it's not.
Okay. So you have that code in every card?
Yes.
Yeah, that sucks.
Yeah.
Right? I mean, so how would you make, what would you have to change for that in the template?
Like similar to what we did with the Google News thing, because I had a template for that.
You
where
put a line across the top that says list filter is current tag card.
Yeah.
And then the next line would say list filter equals tag title. And then you need another closed list at the bottom. Put that in template called card template, tag your dollar sign tags to your template, and then you eliminate all the code and all your buttons.
Eight, yeah.
Seven, eight, seven, eight lines to eight.